In this video, I'd like to talk about adding topics, floating topics, shapes, callouts, and boundaries. To add a new topic as a sibling of the topic you have selected, just press Enter. To add a sibling above the selected topic, press Shift and Enter. And to add a subtopic, press Insert. Normally, you'll just have one central topic and all the subtopics as descendants of it. And if you need another mind map, it'll be on another canvas. But occasionally, you may need to add a floating topic that's not connected to the main mind map at all. This is accomplished using floating topics. To add a floating topic, select the Home tab and the pop-up menu on Insert Topic and choose to add a floating topic. You should be aware that although floating topics look like other mind maps on the same canvas, they are different in several important ways. They're not included as part of the normal outline of topics and are instead added at the end of the outline. They're also secondary as far as layout is concerned, and if the actual mind map bumps into a floating topic or any of its descendant topics, the floating topic will be pushed out of the way. Callouts are a way of annotating topics by an item that's visually connected to the main topic, for instance, like a speech bubble. To add a callout, select the topic you want to add it to and use the Insert Callout option on the ribbon. When it comes to arranging the mind map, the subtopics will have precedence and push the callouts out of the way if necessary. Callouts can have subtopics, callouts of their own, and shapes attached to them, just like an ordinary topic. To visually group topics, you can insert a boundary around them. Just select the topic and use the Insert Boundary option. Boundaries are a good way of spacing out groups of items without needing to manually move topics. The advanced boundary formatting options include a number of different shapes, as well as the ability to set the margin between the topics and the boundary itself to add to the visual separation. Shapes are a unique feature of NovaMind and allow you to add shapes or images that are attached to topics but not part of them. On the Insert menu, you'll see the types of shapes that you can add. Shapes give you a lot of flexibility of layout with a topic because you're not limited to just staying within the confines of the topic shape. Instead, you can add the shapes so that they overlap the topic and either be in front of or behind the topic, which adds a lot of visual interest. You can also include text on any of the shapes, so you can have visual annotations to your topics. Shapes normally push other topics out of the way, apart from the one that it's attached to. But if you want to, you can use the context menu, and under the Layout option, there's an option to ignore the shape when doing layout. When you select this option, it will not push the other topics out of the way, and you can have a shape that's behind or in front of a number of topics. This gives you a massive amount of flexibility in layout for your mind map. Note that if the shape is inside a boundary, it will still push the boundary out. This is so that you have the added flexibility with the combination of shapes and boundaries. So if you do have boundaries and you want a shape that's completely independent from this, then you could attach it either to a parent topic outside the boundary or to the mind map title. Of course, if you do this, then you're effectively saying, I'm taking over the positioning of this shape, and if the other topics move in relationship to it, you may need to move it manually to where you want it.